Hello, everybody. Welcome to this week's show about what's going on around Tizown. What's the dealio? Okay, we've got some special news that I really want to get to because I'm super excited about it. So I'm just going to hurry this up. First off, the library has lots of different story times this week, so bust out your planner and book it. Next, this week's Bogart film is To Have and Have Not. You should go. Don't ask why or why not. Also, Waters Creek has a new daily boot camp. I know my boots are ready for a retreat. Oh, and tickets are now on sale at the Allen Event Center for the opening night performance by Reba McEntire. She's my all-time favorite singer with red hair.
Hello, and welcome to another edition of Access Allen. I'm your host, Scott Evans. In today's episode, we go bargain shopping with Allen Community Outreach, we unveil some new public artwork, and we get a visit from one of sport's oldest trophies. All this and more is coming up right now. In today's economy, we're all on the lookout for good bargains, and the perfect place to find them is the newly remodeled Allen Community Outreach Resale Shop. And the best part is that it all goes back to help those in need.
We feel this is a perfect time to unveil the artwork on Stacy Road.
The official title is Jazz Medley from Nevelson to Village Logo. It's more than just a drive-by decorative object. There's a lot of meaning infused into it. Trying to determine what that meaning is will be different for everyone. That's the way art is. We all interpret art differently, and in a way, this is an analogy to that. And I hope you'll take the time to take a closer look.
It'll be done all the way to Hardin before the end of the year also. So all three major roads in and around the project done before we even start construction. Well, I guess we're going to go out on the site maybe and walk and let people actually see the site and see where things are going to go.
See what it looks like. Now that we're here, and we can actually get a visual of things that are going on, why don't we just kind of just stand here and look around and kind of give me a boundary where we're at, you know, the roads and all.
Well, we're on Ridgeview, and Ridgeview Drive will be done, as you said, around November. As you can see, they've got it ready to put in the next two lanes going westbound here, and that'll complete this as a four-lane divided road. Connecting down to Exchange, you know, to our east, Exchange goes right through the heart of the property.
All right, I think our sliders are almost done. What's the temperature on those, Trevor?
We've got just about a 160 going there.
That's exactly what we want for the beef sliders. How about the other ones? You already checked those?
No, but I think I should put this in sanitation water.
You got it. Let me go ahead and sanitize this for you real quick. Of course, we have our water here with 1 teaspoon of bleach, our sanitizer. Here we go. Give that a shot, Trevor.
I'll give it right back to you. I got to get the lamb now.
The goal temperature with this lamb and with the turkey is 165 degrees.
All right, we got that on the lamb.
165 degrees?
165 on the lamb.
All right, quick rinse and our sanitizer. All right.
The reason why we want to do this so quick is we don't want to overcook these sliders.
That's right. You want to get them just right, the right temperature, 165, because if you get over that, they're going to be really dry, and we don't want that in our sliders.
All right. These are good too, Joey.
165 degrees?
165.
All right. I think we got to plate some of these up. What do you think?
All right. Sounds good.
Welcome to the City of Allen's Year in Review. In this program, city and community leaders will highlight departmental accomplishments for fiscal year 2008 through 2009. I'm your host, Shannon Oliver. Planning today for tomorrow's challenges. It's a philosophy that Allen City Council takes to heart. Through annual strategic planning, the City Council establishes a vision for Allen's exciting future and sets goals to make that vision a reality. Forbes.com lists Allen as one of America's 20 best places to move, and Money Magazine includes the city in its top 20 places to live.
My name's Jonathan Boyd. I'm a division chief here at the Allen Fire Department. Part of my job is training firefighters to be ready to respond to emergency incidents, including fires. We'll have all four of us running it, and I'll be the incident command, and we'll just operate it like it's a real fire. We use simulations in our training to try to help people get that experience that we can't give them without years of experience. If he's red flashing and you hear screaming, that's you getting burned, or if you don't have your mask on, you'll hear him coughing, that's you. So what we do is we simulate that here in our sim lab. All right, let's do a scenario.
I consider the stained glass windows that are featured in this church one of the most important historical resources that Allen has, mainly because of the detail and the beauty in the windows. They feature the names of early pioneers and, of course, the 12-toed Jesus. This building is the centerpiece of the Allen Heritage Village. The village centered around the church will have different houses on either side, and this church is exactly in the middle of the future village.
Today we are out here conducting a quasi-experiment using household chemicals, creating a solution that you can place your tree into and it will fire retard your tree.
So we purchased two identical trees from the same lot. One was treated with the solution, one was not treated with the solution, to see whether or not using a specific type of solution that was recommended from one of the burn centers would slow the process down of the burning of a tree.
Ready?
Welcome to the City of Allen. You are watching Allen City Television, your local municipal information station.
The Friends of the Allen Public Library invite you to participate in the 2009 to 2010 Allen Reads program. This year's featured book is The Cellist of Sarajevo by Stephen Galloway.
This comes from Robert Davis. He wants to know what happened to Charlie Effinger.
Charlie Effinger has, I guess what they diagnosed as a severe grade one concussion after that hit he took the other night. And he's been put on the 14-day IR. As we speak, we're looking for another goaltender to come in here to maybe relieve Witz here. But. You know, we'll evaluate Charlie as it goes. And again, this concussion stuff, you really got to watch it. But our main concern, obviously, is to make sure Charlie's healthy before he gets back on the net.
Coach Mack, you mind if we take a question from the audience here?
Sure.
All right. Good.
The question I had you just answered was, what was the status of Charlie Effinger?
Yeah.
And the other part of the question was, what has the league done to the player from the Brahmas that took that cheap shot?
We're out here with Montgomery Farms and Leave No Trace and Allen Park System and KayakPower.com. Today we're doing a free kayak demonstration. People can come out, use our kayaks, paddle around. We teach the basic paddling and we get into the environmental issues, you know, clean up, don't leave any trash. But it's a great family environment to bring your kids out and learn these things and be on the water. And they're having a great time. The kids are really enjoying it.
Too bad.
Did you just do a run?
I just came for the hot chocolate.
Excuse me.
Yes.
Why are you running?
Oh, love Rudolph. Always am.
Awesome.
Well, continue on with your big finish.
Thank you.
Run, run, Rudolph. Santa's gotta make it to town.
I just ran the whole entire thing, and I'm not even really out of breath, so I think next year I should actually win instead of finishing somewhat close to last place.
Good job, guys! You guys are doing great! Finish strong!
We're nearing the end of the Rudolph run. What a great morning it's been. We laughed. We sweated. I quit. We broke some boards. Yeah! It's been another successful year for the Rudolph run. We'll see you next year.